We're going to use some of the words of the famous hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, to lead us into our prayers. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the privilege of coming to you in prayer, to praise you for who you are, and to bring before you our joys and our sorrows. Lord Jesus, thank you that you rejoice with us in the good times, when we meet with friends and family, when we celebrate weddings and new births, when we marvel at the beauty of your creation, and when we use the gifts and talents that you've given us, and when we come together to praise you in our homes and our churches. Lord, you also understand and meet us in our sorrows. We pray today especially for your comfort for all those who grieve and mourn. We know that you experienced grief at the loss of John. In your grief, you went to a quiet place to reflect and to pray to the Father. There are many now experiencing the grief of bereavement caused by COVID, but also by other conditions brought on by age or ill health. The pain of loss is immense, and we can feel so lost and helpless in the face of death. Father, we know that pain of grief is not the only cost of bereavement. There are so many practical needs to be met. Help us as individuals and as a church to see these needs and to respond to them. Show us how we can help, how we can bring your loving kindness into these dark days. Father, we want to pray for families who have not been able to be with their loved ones in their last days, or who have not been able to meet the others to grieve and share memories in funeral services. Help us to find ways to celebrate and to remember the lives of those we have loved. We thank you for the amazing service of doctors, nurses, and care workers who have battled so hard to save lives. Thank you too that when lives have been lost, so many have stayed beside their patients to the end. Comfort these caring men and women as they deal with their own grief at the experiences they have gone through. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with a load of care? Precious Saviour, still our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Lord, many around us are battling with grief, other than for the loss of loved ones. For many, economic uncertainties have led to furlough or redundancy. Incomes may be restricted or disappear altogether, but bills keep coming and mouths still need to be fed. Debts begin to mount, and the pressure of debt weighs heavily. We've been learning about the generosity of those in the early church, and we pray that you'll show us ways that we can be generous to others. Thank you for all the many examples of practical love and support we've seen during this current crisis. Lord, we pray particularly for the work of food banks, of debt relief agencies, and many other charities. We also pray for the work of the government as it tries to restore the economy. Please direct support to the people and places that need it the most. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Blessed Saviour, thou hast promised thou wilt all our burdens bear. May we ever, Lord, be bringing all to thee in earnest prayer. We now invite you all, in a moment of quiet, to name before Jesus all those we know who are struggling with grief. Grief for the loss of loved ones, for the loss of employment, for the loss of companionship, and for lost opportunities and aspirations. Draw near and bring your comfort and healing to us all. Lord, we thank you that you are a loving God who hears our prayers, who weeps with us and comforts us as we bring our sorrow to you. We know that you have promised to be with us always. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers. For the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.